This is a simple web application which has a connection string in the appsettings.config and uses that to connect to a SQL database and retrieve data. In the startup.cs of the application, the SQL connection is set up using the connection string from the config. Under appsettings.json, there is a configuration for the connection string. However, that's left blank. Usually, I save it as part of the manage user secrets to keep this out of source control. The connection string has a database server, a database name, the user ID to connect to it, and a password. This is usually the pattern that we use to connect to a SQL database. If you're using Azure as your cloud service, Azure SQL does support using Azure AD authentication. This means that it also supports managed identities. Azure AD provides us an automatically managed identity, which can be used to connect to Azure resources. This allows us to connect to the database without the need of any username or password explicitly being there in the code. In this video, let's look at how to connect a web application running on Azure to connect to an Azure SQL database using managed identity. Hello everyone, my name is Rahul and welcome to my YouTube channel. To start with, let's remove username and password from the connection string because we don't need that anymore and that is our end goal. With that gone, this is no longer a sensitive information, so I can easily copy this and put this into appsettings.json. If you choose to keep it as part of secrets.json, feel free to do that. In this case, let me remove it from here and move that into appsettings.json. When we make a SQL connection, we'll need to use a managed identity token to connect to SQL Server. So let's modify this code a bit and set up the token access. The SQL connection has a property access token, which can be used to set the Azure AD token. In the previous video, we saw how we can use default Azure credential to retrieve an Azure AD token. I have added the Azure identity as a NuGet package. Let's create a new instance of default Azure credential from the Azure.identity. This can be used to get the token. The credential.getToken, to which you need to pass a new token request context and pass in an array of resources against which you need the token for. We want this for the database.windows.net, so let's use that. Set the access token from the token retrieved using default Azure credential. In a previous video, we saw how to set up local development environment for default Azure credential. You can either use the environment variables option or token cache credentials. Please check the video linked in the description for further details. With that set up, we have the SQL connection now using the access token. The quotes controller takes in a SQL connection and uses a simple query from the database to retrieve the data. Let's put a breakpoint in the access token code and run this to check if it's all working. It hits the quotes endpoint and the breakpoint. We are able to successfully get the token using the Azure credential and it's getting set to the SQL connection. Let's run this through and we can see that there is an exception. Currently, I'm using the token cache credentials set from Azure Service Authentication to retrieve the token. We need to grant this user permissions to the database. Let's head to the Azure SQL database in the Azure portal and go to Azure Active Directory Admin. To set up managed service identity for the SQL Server, we need to be under the context of the Azure Active Directory authentication. We cannot be under the subscription authentication. For now, let me set myself as the admin in this database. Now that I have access to this database, let's rerun the application to see if this works. I'm still getting the token back as expected and it hits the database successfully. SQL Server by default restricts all IPs accessing the data and it needs to be explicitly whitelisted. Let's head back to the portal and under the firewalls and virtual networks, you can add in the IP address. You can use the add client IP, which will add the current client's IP address to this exception list. With the firewall rules updated, let's navigate back to the API and see if we are able to get the data back. We are successfully able to retrieve the data from the database from our local host. Note that I made myself admin in this case. However, you might choose to have a different AD application or an AD group or your team members added explicitly into roles, which we will see in a minute. This application is currently working fine on my local host. Let's publish this into Azure and see how we can set up for Azure Web App. From Visual Studio, for the project, right-click and click Publish. I have everything set up here to a web app, so let me just publish here. Normally, I have Azure DevOps build release pipeline to set this up. Let's go to the slash quotes endpoint for the published website. It returns a 500 error. This is most likely because we have not set up the managed identity for the website and also not added the IP address. So let's head back to the Azure portal and go to the web app. This is the application to which I have just deployed it. To get the IP address for this, we can copy this under the custom domains. This is the IP address for this web application. We can use that to update the SQL Server firewall rules the same way we did before. So let's give the web app as the rule name and give in the IP address. With the IP address set, let's go back to the Azure web app and turn on managed identity. You can turn on managed identity from the identity section under the settings. Turn this on and click save. This creates a service principle for this web application under the same name as of the web app. We now need to give access for this web application to the SQL Server. To give the managed identity access to the Azure SQL, we need to be logged in to the SQL under the context of the AD admin. So let's open up SQL Server Management Studio and connect to the database using the AD admin. Let's connect to the Azure SQL database and use Active Directory password from the dropdown and give in the username and the password. I can see the database from the Azure SQL. Let's run a query to set up access for the Azure Managed Service Identity. Here, I'm creating a user for the Quotes app, which is exactly the identity name that's the same name as that of the web application. Using that name and specifying it as an external provider, I'm giving it the reader, writer, and the admin access. You could choose to manage your access, so I can just give reader and writer, for example. This creates a new user for the database. Let us refresh the database and make sure that the user is created as expected. Under the database security users, we can see the user that we just created. With that access granted, I think we should be good to hit the API endpoint and verify if we are able to get the data back. And it is successfully retrieving data from the SQL database. We have successfully connected to the Azure SQL from the web application running in Azure without explicitly specifying any user ID or password. Azure is managing us the credentials for that. All we are saying is just granting that user access to the database. When using Entity Framework to talk to your database, you can set that up to connect to the database as well. So under Startup, instead of specifying the SQL connection, we might add in the DB context and set this up for SQL Server connection. So using Use SQL Server and pass in the connection string. The connection string still does not have the username and password. EFCO still doesn't have full support for Azure AD access. The easiest way to set up is when your code context is created, get the underlying DB connection and specify explicitly the access token on the connection. We've used the same default Azure credential from the Azure SDK class and getting the token against the same resource. Once that's retrieved, we are setting it as part of access token like we saw before. Running this, we should be able to get the data back as expected. If you go to Quotes controller and instead of the SQL connection, get in the Quotes context, rename this to context and create a new property context. And using the context, I can simply say where Quotes is equal to context.quote.toList async, which will retrieve all the data from this. Once retrieved, I can return that. Let's run this to verify it's working fine. It's now using Entity Framework Core using Azure AD token. There is an existing issue under AFCO to add first-class support for the Azure Access token. There are a few better workarounds how you can set up these connections, which I will link in the description below. We've removed the need of any credentials in the source code or when it is deployed. This is one less secure information to be managed and explicitly managed by the infrastructure. If you found this video useful, please hit the like button. And if you want to be notified in the future of similar videos, please subscribe. Thank you.